good, everybody? Welcome to an Epic My Damn Toys video. Today, ladies and gentlemen, we have a brand new WWE Elite action figure video for you guys, and it is time to name the best WWE figures of 2020. This is mainly going to be Elites and Ultimates. I'm not going to get into the basics, guys. I don't really collect the basics, and if a basic is damn good, I'll tell you about it. Firefly Funhouse Bray Wyatt's the best basic all year. That's all you need to know. But I know there's like 3 weeks left in the year of 2020. Thank Christ. Everybody knows 2020 has been, been pretty shitty, but today we're gonna lift our spirits a little bit. We're gonna get into the best parts of WWE Elite action figures in this year. You know, while it's been a pretty crappy year to say the least, it has been an epic year to be a WWE action figure collector, specifically of the main Elite and Ultimate Edition lines. Man, they absolutely knocked it out of the park. And in today's video, we're gonna get this floppy doppy right here. What the hell is this? It won't stay on there. F it. Anyways, since there are only 21 days left or 3 weeks or so in the year of 2020, guys, we are going to be diving into the best figures of the year simply because the Elite 83 pre-order that is supposed to be coming out very soon is not scheduled until early January, meaning that everything that we have so far is pretty much it for the year 2020. If Elite 83 ends up releasing, well, retail's not going to get it until 2021 anyway, so I think this is a good basis for what we're going to get for the year 2020 as far as Mattel WWE figures are concerned. So let's dive into the best WWE Elite figures of 2020, and I will have a personal top 10 going up when we get closer to the end of the year. I also feel like this video has way more figures than last year's video. I could be tripping, but I'm pretty sure that's correct. But diving in first, guys, we have Elite 81 Steve Austin. This is a beautiful looking figure. I could not leave this one off the list. Look at this head sculpt. It's a great head sculpt. You get the WCW Tag Team Championship, another side of our Brian Pillman. You can finally complete your tag team there for the Hollywood Blondes, and this figure looks great. Great entrance jacket. Great attire, white boots. It's just a standalone good figure, especially for flashbacks. This is a damn good one. Next up, guys, we have our tag teams. Specifically, let's dive into the New Day. New Day got their best Elite set this year. You have Kofi Kingston. Now, I did do a little fix-up on mine. The shoes are different, but this pink, blue, purplish color, like the cotton candy, looks really, really damn good. And all three of the New Day were looking outstanding. This is a part of Elite Series 78 and 79. I think Big E was Elite 79, Xavier Woods was 79, and Kofi Kingston was Elite 78, but these attires look absolutely wonderful on all three of them. Their head sculpts are great. You got the up, up, down, down championship with Xavier Woods, and I know this didn't have these shoes on there. They had the light blue shoes on there, but nonetheless, these are definitely our best iterations of the New Day, and I'm excited to see where they go from here, but these are definitely their best Elites, and they came in this year. Next up, guys, is going to be the Top Picks Fiend Elite figure. Now, we do have an Ultimate Edition of this, and we'll get into that later, as you guys can see in the back there, but this Top Picks figure is great. While it wasn't a perfect figure, I think that Mattel did a great job. Everyone was super hyped up for this figure, and I think it definitely delivered. It's not perfect by any means. I still feel like the legs are a bit stumpy. The red color isn't the most accurate, but as far as a great action figure, you gotta have an Elite Fiend figure, and the Top Picks is better since the blonde is more accurate over the Elite 77. So I put the Top Picks in here over the Elite 77. Next up, guys, we have our women's figures, right? This year was the year of the women's figures, man. I mean, we had Elite 80 Bayley in the house. She kicked some ass. We had the Elite 78 Naomi in the house. She kicked some ass. And we finally got a Chyna figure, which we thought we'd never see, right? We got Chyna in the set. And not only did we get one Chyna, guys, but we got two Chyna. You have the DX 2-pack with the Triple H, and we also have the new WrestleMania figure from her match at WrestleMania 17 or X7. And both of these are absolutely fantastic. You get your two different kind of versions of Chyna here. I love this figure head to toe. I think I like the WrestleMania one better, but if you're going off your, you know, the Chyna that you think of in memory, you gotta go with the all black right here, but both of them are looking really good. I'm so excited for Chyna figures. I think we even have more coming on, but the Chyna figures were over the top this year, and like I was talking about, guys, you have the Elite 80 Bayley, the Elite 78 Naomi. Both of these had double-jointed knees. The women's articulation was approved upon, where it seems like we're getting better and better with women's articulation and figures. Now we're just waiting on ankle pivot. I know some of the figures have ankle pivot, but not only do you have these two guys, you have Io Shirai that was featured in here. Probably my favorite women's figure of the year has to be the Elite 81 Bianca Belair. Bianca Belair's figure is super fantastic, super poseable, great head sculpt. She has the Charlotte Ultimate Edition boots, so she has the toe articulation and the ankle rocker, and she includes the cloth jacket. So women's figures are going to continue to improve. I know we had the double jointed knees nearing the end of 2019 with the Becky Lynch Elite 72, but we took it a step further this year because we had a couple Ultimate Editions. We had the Ultimate Edition Becky Lynch, and then we had the Ultimate Edition Charlotte Flair, and I just ruined everything. every damn thing. But Ultimate Edition Charlotte Flair was another beautiful one, man. I'm just so excited for the women's figures. You know, we are adding an MDT women's division, and the first matchup for the women is going to be at My Damn Nation for the MDT Women's Championship. So experimenting and posing around with all of these women's figures is going to be super fun, and I'm so glad that Mattel has decided to upgrade these things, and they're going to be great, and I'm sure that 2021 is going to be even better for years of the women. You could have put Lacey Evans in here, but these were my all-time favorite figures of the year for the women's figures, and I don't really like Lacey Evans that much. Next up, guys, we have Survivor Series Elite John Morrison. John Morrison was a guy that came back to WWE nearing the end of 2019. He may have been here early 2020. I want to say it was the end of 2019. I can't remember. Who the hell cares? All we care about is getting our John Morrison Elite figures. We had the Survivor Series figure, which is a throwback flashback John Morrison, and then we had the Elite 82, which is the upgraded today 2020 John Morrison, and both of these look absolutely beautiful. I'm so happy to add more John Morrisons to the collection. This cloth jacket was immaculate. The likeness is immaculate. The posability is great, and I'm looking forward to more John Morrisons. We need an all-white attire with white coat of John Morrison. Please give it to us. Next up, guys, we had a guy that we didn't even think we'd be getting ever, right? We have Mr. T, and not only did we get Mr. T, guys, but we have the San Diego Comic-Con exclusive. Then we have the WrestleMania 2 boxing match between Mr. T and Roddy Piper, and not only is this SDCC so beautiful with the gold rings and the belt and the attire and the head sculpt and the camo and stuff, but this boxing gear with the interchangeable boxing gloves, the robe, the head sculpt on Roddy Piper is freaking fantastic. You have this shorts mold that I really enjoy. We're advancing towards pinless joints now, and I loved reviewing all of these figures, man. Having Mr. T in the set, I'm sure this is, you know, a sign of more celebrities to come, but yeah, man, you couldn't go on for 2020 of the best figures of the year without including some of these. My mind's actually still kind of blown that we have Mr. T in our figure collections. Next up, guys, is another version of Kofi Kingston. We have the Top Picks version, but it is a fix-up, but I loved this attire. I thought it was great. It originally had this head sculpt on it in the blonde, but I did a couple fix-ups here, kind of interacting two different figures here with arms and feet and head swaps here, but these two figures were great. The Top Picks was good. I know this figure wasn't in there, but this head sculpt and arms are supposed to be over here, but you guys can see the vision. I like the Top Picks new Kofi. We had Legends figures that were excellent this year, right? We had the Ultimate Warrior Legends figure. We had the Eddie Guerrero Legends figure. We had the Elite 77 Rick Rude figure doing a face slide. We had some more Legends thrown up in here, guys. You can't leave out the iconic, the legendary man who retired this year, the 30-year anniversary of Undertaker with his Decade of Domination figure, as well as the Elite 79, which was in celebration of the 30 years of Undertaker. So this, of course, isn't all of our Legends, but I wanted to kind of get all of these together. The Elite 79 was a beautiful figure. I love the head sculpt. It didn't come with this trench coat, but his attire was really, really nice. The Elite 77 Rick Rude was super nice as well. I love this boot color and everything like that. Simply ravishing is one way to describe this figure right here. Having this Legends Eddie Guerrero is super surreal, man. We haven't had a Eddie Guerrero Elite figure since the Legends figure with the from the No Way Out gear. And having this figure with the I'm Your Poppy t-shirt that's not featured in the video here today, but you can go check out our review. This figure is phenomenal. It's definitely going to be in my top 10 for sure. And I just get crazy nostalgia feels looking at that figure. You have the suited Ultimate Warrior, which I also love. Great moment and, you know, a great suited body for other characters. And then the Decade of Domination debut Undertaker with the tie and the beautiful coat and the head sculpt on this guy. I mean, good lord. This head sculpt, this whole figure is absolutely brilliant. And it's kind of flying off shelves. I feel like the Decade of Domination wave did really, really well. I don't feel like I've seen it anywhere. When I see it, it's gone the next time I go. So, and it's not me buying them. I buy my set and then I let it do its thing, and they are definitely selling well. Up next, guys, we have a couple more guys. We got the Elite 75 Pete Dunne and the Elite 78 R-Truth. Now, one thing I will say, let's go ahead and knock out Elite 75, because I got some things I want to say about Elite 75. Okay, so we have Elite 75 Seth Rollins, Pete Dunne. Also a part of that series was Elite 75 Hurricane. I'm sure there was another figure, right? Hell yeah, Elite 75 Kalisto over here. 2020 has been so taxing on my brain and so damn long. This year has felt like forever. How in the hell was Elite 75 the first set we got? I feel like we got this set 2 years ago. That's how long 2020 has been, but this Kalisto is absolutely brilliant. That whole set was really good. You still had Mandy Rose and Jeff Hardy in that set. I left those out of here. I felt like the Mandy Rose could have been a little bit thicker on her parts. I felt like it didn't give her as much muscle as she needed, as well as the Jeff Hardy. I was really let down by the head sculpt, but you know, the fix-ups and stuff are running wild with that figure, but having Hurricane in our collections, the Royal Rumble winning Seth Rollins, an updated Pete Dunne and Kalisto, all that whole set was actually pretty damn solid, and it was probably one of the better sets of the year. Maybe we can do an Elite Set of the Year reviewing each Elite set, but this wave was underrated and it was damn good. Getting into Elite 78, guys, guys. We have at least 78 R-Truth, our first updated R-Truth in like 50 series or something like that. It came with our first ever 24/7 championship. Also a part of this wave was a 24/7 God. We had the Drake Maverick figure, which was super underrated. I don't think a lot of people had this in their top figures of the year. Once you switch out the hands, I did put on some like women's figure hands for this, and it makes it look actually really, really decent. I like the way it looks a lot after switching out those hands. We also had Elite Series 78 Randy Orton. Oh, God in heaven. F it. We're just going to keep rolling. God in heaven. People just dropping like flies. But yeah, Drake Maverick. You had R-Truth. You had Randy Orton. You had Naomi, which we covered before, and we also had Matt Riddle in this set. And the Matt Riddle, I almost didn't even include in the video, guys, simply because you guys know he had that arm issue that I don't like his torso that they used, really. You know, he had the beautiful jacket, though. It is our first Elite Matt Riddle, but, and he did come with some great accessories, and I like the attire. It's just these arms. Like, why are they giving him Kalisto or Rey Mysterio arms? What kind of shish does that make? But nonetheless, Elite 78 was a solid set. I love this Randy Orton. I like the head sculpt on it. I did throw this hoodie on there, but this was a great set. I think that it was a pretty solid set, and Elite 78 had some features here today. Next up, guys, is the Top Picks Braun Strowman figure. Now, I did remove the hair and made him bald to give him the more accurate look, but this figure was pretty damn good. I love the head sculpt on it. I like that we finally got a shirtless Braun. This definitely had to be included. Speaking of Top Picks figures, guys, you also have the Top Picks Ricochet, which was also a great figure. I love this gray attire. You could have put the Elite 80 in here, but I think the silver or gray attire here is better. Also, the tattoo doesn't go over the wrist tape like on the Elite 80, and I really enjoyed this Ricochet figure. You also have to include the Survivor Series figures. Now, we have the Survivor Series Drew McIntyre, which he also got a Top Picks figure this year, but I like the Survivor Series better. I like the logos here and everything going on in the back. This actually may be the Top Picks. I can't freaking remember. I think it's the Survivor Series. Who the hell cares? They're basically the same damn figure. Of course, you have to include the Elite 79 / Top Picks Roman Reigns that had the updated gauntlet technology, fisted hands, the gold vest, and the interchangeable heads with the ponytail head sculpt. That was also really huge for these figures. And one of our last Top Picks figures in this wave, people dropping like effing flies again. You have the Top Picks Seth Rollins, which a lot of people probably wouldn't include this figure simply because it is missing the X-Man vest for the X-Man attire right here from Extreme Rules, but I wanted to include it. I like this figure. I like everything going on. I think it was Extreme Rules. Again, who cares? Beautiful looking gear. I liked all three of these figures, and if you guys wanted updated versions of these, those are the ways to go. Now, among figures of the year, guys, this year was the year of the tag team, I swear to God. Now, up first, we do have Montez Ford from the Street Profits. I think that Montez Ford definitely got the better cut of the cloth than the Angelo Dawkins. I do not really care for that Angelo Dawkins whatsoever, but Montez Ford came in looking really good. I like his figure a lot. I like the head sculpt, the body. One thing I wasn't impressed with was no lower calf rotation, just the foot rotation. That kind of bummed me out a little bit, but I do like the Montez Ford figure. We also have Eric and Ivar in the Viking Raiders. Now, both of these are highly detailed, even though, now Eric did have Johnny Gargano syndrome that we fixed. He had the short kick pads. We switched those out, but having both of these is great. The Eric figure and the Ivar are actually super poseable. Actually, just Ivar. Eric's kind of stiffy liffy, but the Viking Raiders came in looking excellent. Among those tag teams, we also had Heavy Machinery, and probably one of the most underrated figures of the year has to be Otis. When we first got this, I was really worried how he would pose around, but sculpting the knee pad over the knee joint and this new boot articulation and like the way this figure feels in the hand is quite outstanding. It's not loosey-goosey at all. It can move around and do all the things you need it to do, and it was a really shocking figure, and I'm not a big fan of Otis that much, but this figure rocks ass. I don't even know what that means. Next up, guys, is the Undisputed Era. We finally got our camo gear. I didn't get my camo gear, Kyle O'Reilly. You guys know the story behind that, but Bobby Fish and Kyle O'Reilly in the War Games gear to go with our Roderick Strong. Hopefully, we get an Adam Cole soon enough, but both of these figures were absolutely outstanding. The head sculpts were great, except for Bobby. I switched his up, but Kyle looks good. I was really excited to have these, and I do have three of the Chase variant with no camo gear, but hopefully that changes soon. We also have to talk about our big man, right? We got to get into the Elite 82 Keith Lee. Holy Christ, what a great figure this was this year. Super poseable, on ball joints, can do all the things you need him to do. Looks just like Keith Lee. I put smaller knee pads on mine, but this figure is a beast to go along with, or not go along with, but to, you know, put up next to our Walter figure, the ringside exclusive Walter. Beautiful figure head to toe. If you want two giants to step in the ring, here's a great matchup for you. Walter and Keith Lee were both great figures. I love the entrance robe here for Walter. The head sculpt looks great. He looks like Groot, of course, but they did an outstanding job on that ringside exclusive, and Keith Lee is just a beast. Coming into our last few guys here, starting out first, we do have our two-pack of Rey Mysterio and Samoa Joe from WrestleMania 30. 35. The fact that this figure is from this year, I could have sworn it was from last year. I could be wrong, but I think this figure was from this year. If it wasn't from this year, then don't mind me, but this figure is a beast. And now that I'm thinking about it, I feel like it was from last year, but the Mysterio Rey Mysterio is absolutely detailed as hell, and it feels really good in the hand. One thing I'll say is the head sculpt's a little big, but this figure is straight fire. You need to put this in your collection, no doubt. I need more of these to do fix-ups, but Jesus, man, this thing rules. Up next, guys, we do have Survivor Series Kane. Now, this is pretty much a repaint of the ringside exclusive Hardcore Kane, but dude, what a freaking amazing figure. Early 2000s Kane is one of my favorite things to look at. Of course, this figure did have a ton of problems, a ton of inaccuracies. I mean, they didn't even paint on the studs on the belt. We did a fix-up on one of ours, but I wanted to put the factory one in here simply because having this figure is great. They got the glossiness on the boots, but having a mask Kane from the early 2000s is just something I can't leave off the list. Next up is one of my favorites, or two of my favorite wrestlers in all of wrestling. Both of them and their updated figures for this year were outstanding. We got my boy KO and we had Finn Balor, Elite 80 KO and Elite 82 Finn Balor. Probably going to be up there on my list. I know Kevin Owens definitely needed an upgrade. When this figure first released, he had a really like ginger looking beard, but after I did the fix up, it was impossible not to include it in the video, man. I love the updated tattoos, the Stun Owens stun. I've been waiting on a long beard like this for our Kevin Owens, and having this updated head sculpt, I did repaint the head sculpt, but after that repaint, bro, and after all the tattoo updates and stuff, this figure is phenomenal. And then Finn Balor speaks for itself. I mean, look at this head sculpt. I've been waiting on an updated head sculpt, a long beard, thick beard Finn Balor, and it is the heel NXT Finn Balor. I did throw the championship and the jacket on there, but the X attire with the black and the gun shooter hands that we've been waiting on forever. He came with two gun shooter hands. He has all of his updated tattoos on it. This figure had to be on my list, and it for sure will be in my top 10. We'll have to see where it ranks at the end, but these two are two of my favorites of the year, and I wanted to include them here at the end. And then getting into our Ultimate Editions, guys, this year, Mattel kicked absolute ass with these Ulta. Oh my God. Mattel kicked ass this year with the Ultimate Editions, man. Starting out with Ultimate Edition 4 HBK. Now, I could have sworn when I looked it up to find out what figures released this year, I did not remember that Ultimate Edition Series 4 HBK and Brock Lesnar were in here, because this Brock Lesnar is one of my favorite Ultimate Editions ever, and I could have sworn it was from last year, but apparently not. I could be wrong, but I posted my review of this in like February 1st or something, and the fact that these two released this year blows my damn mind. It's a lot like Elite 75. I guess I just feel like January and February were a whole year ago because of 2020 and how shitty and long it felt. Both of these go hard in the paint, and speaking of which, these four back here show no mercy as well. The Ultimate Edition John Cena. John Cena is my favorite of all time, so having this yelling head sculpt makes just tears come to my eyes. The double jointed arms, the 2008 Royal Rumble gear is absolutely fantastic. The hat is great as well, this attire. I already had it in my collection, but getting it in there officially from Mattel, and I hate that the ankle joints are loosey-goosey, and look at this toe pivot that's kind of loosey, but dude, this figure is still a beast, and I love the double jointed arms and the accessories that come with it. We also have The Rock, which had a ton of accessibility with it. One of my favorite reviews of the year comes with the cloth t-shirt. You have the double jointed arms right here. You have the Just Bring It hands, the yelling head sculpt with the glasses. This figure was a ton of fun as well. Every Ultimate Edition that Mattel gives us, they just totally kick ass on it. I wish they'd change the torsos, but man, the accessories and the articulation on these is brilliant. And then finally, finishing it off, guys, I mean, these are probably going to be one and two on a lot of people's like best figures of the year. You have the much long-awaited Hollywood Hulk Hogan Ultimate Edition and the Ultimate Edition Fiend figure with the jacket and the double jointed arms. Interchangeable tongue-out head sculpt. I think that these two will probably be ranked near the top for everyone, and it just remains true that these are really damn good, especially Hollywood Hulk Hogan, the NWO Hulk Hogan. We've been waiting on this Hollywood Hulk Hogan for years upon years now. I think it's been like 5 years since we've been waiting on it. You have all of the beautiful gear. You got the Hollywood on the butt, NWO on the weight belt. He has all of his great head sculpts. He's got the iconic look, and just having Hulk Hogan figures back in our collections, back from Mattel officially, and it being Hollywood Hulk Hogan brings a lot of nostalgia. It is just a beast to go along with our Ultimate Edition Fiend, but that pretty much is all of the best figures of 2020. I know it seemed like a ton, but Mattel really brought it this year, man. I mean, they did a lot of great things, like as far as accessories, double jointed arms. The accessories were killer this year. The attires we got were killer this year. The new characters we got. I mean, I was just impressed, bro. But let's stack them all up here behind here so you guys guys can see how damn big this pile is. Well, there's the giant pile behind The Fiend and the Hollywood Hulk Hogan. But before we get out of here, guys, I do want to give a random shout out from our video yesterday. If you guys missed that, definitely go check that out. This shout out is going to go to RJW Corporations. He says, dang, they may want to change the commercial advertising to collect them all. My wallet ain't that full. And he's referring to yesterday's video where we counted every single WWE Elite action figure that they've ever made. And yeah, Brad, it would definitely be quite expensive. If you were to add all of it up as far as the money that it would cost, even if you were to go by like eBay prices, bro, I can't even imagine how much that would cost. But a huge shout out to RJW for that. A lot of you guys didn't even like that video, so go show that video some love. But anyways, guys, I'm getting the hell out of here. Thank you guys so very much for watching. Let me know what your favorite figure of the year was down below, or if you want to wait on the top 10 ranking, let me know down below. I don't know when that video is coming, but it's going to be closer towards the end of the year. You guys know we got the big collection video. We got all the good stuff coming for the end of the year, but I'm getting out of here, guys. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to the channel. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at MyDamnToys, and I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you. You crossed the line.